ओम श्री परमात्मने नमः।
ओम श्री परमात्मने नमः।
नमस्ते ईशान।
नमस्ते कुलदीप मम्मू।
अगेन वन मोर एपिसोड, दिस इज 46th एपिसोड। इन 47th एपिसोड वी विल कंप्लीट चैप्टर 2। ओके, टुडे वी आर डेलिबरेटली टेकिंग ओनली वन श्लोक, एंड दैट श्लोक इज इन व्हाट छंदस, व्हाट छंदस, से दैट अगेन,
इंद्रवज्र
छंदस, राइट। अवर नॉर्मल छंदस इज
अनुष्टुप छंदस,
अनुष्टुप छंदस, वेरी गुड। So today it is going to be Indra Vajra Chandas, and naturally this one shloka itself is equal to two other shlokas, no? There are four lines. Okay. So we are deliberately taking this one shloka today, and next week we will complete chapter 2. So in last shloka, Bhagavan said, worldly things are night for a sage, right?
Yes.
Then how can he live in this world? Bhagavan is giving us answer to this question through this coming shloka. He is giving a beautiful example of ocean being unmoved in spite of water entering it from all sides. We are going to see that. Okay. So let us chant the shloka in Indra Vajra Chandas and a slightly different tune. Okay. Apuryamanam achala pratishtham.
Apuryamanam achala pratishtham.
Samudramapav प्रविशन्ति यद्वते,
समुद्रमापः प्रविशन्ति यद्वते,
तद्वत् कामायं प्रविशन्ति सर्वे,
तद्वत् कामायं प्रविशन्ति सर्वे,
स शान्तिमाप्नोति न कामकामी,
स शान्तिमाप्नोति न कामकामी।
उत्तमम्, अति उत्तमम्। वन्स अगेन, आपूर्यमाणमचल प्रतिष्ठम्,
आपूर्यमाणमचल प्रतिष्ठम्,
समुद्रमापः प्रविशन्ति यद्वते,
समुद्रमापः प्रविशन्ति यद्वते,
तद्वत् कामायं प्रविशन्ति सर्वे,
तद्वत् कामायं प्रविशन्ति सर्वे,
से दैट प्रविशन्ति सर्वे,
प्रविशन्ति सर्वे,
स शान्तिमाप्नोति न कामकामी,
स शान्तिमाप्नोति न कामकामी,
न कामकामी। ममो इज अ म्यूजिशियन, नो? You can chant that also, okay? After a few years, you can chant that way also. But not Veda, Upanishad and all that. They have a peculiar tune, swara and all that. This Bhagavad Gita and other shlokas, we can chant in raga also, okay? Nakamakami. It's new to you, right?
Yes.
Okay, so let us move on to chanting together of this shloka. Okay.
Apuryamanam achala pratishtham, samudramapav pravishanti yadvate, tadvat kamayam pravishanti sarve, सशांति माप्नोति न कामकामी।
यू नो, Let us go through the meanings now. Apuryamanam achala pratishtham
samudramapav pravishanti yadvate
tadvat kamayam pravishanti sarve
sashanti mapnoti nakamakami.
Apuryamanam achala pratishtham samudram yadvat apah pravishanti. First level meaning, just like how the ocean remains unmoved though water enters it from all sides, tadvat yam sarve kamaah pravishanti saha shantim apnoti, so does that individual attain peace in whom all desires enter. Don't get confused, okay? Mama will explain this in a very simple manner. Kamakami na, but not the desirer of desires. Oh, what is this? Don't worry, okay? Mama is going to explain that now. So, let us get into spiritual tidbits and make this clear. Bhagavan is giving us another beautiful example of an individual of steady wisdom. That is what we are talking about, sthita prajna. He is taking ocean as an example. Okay, tell me, ocean is huge, right?
Yes.
And it is also
deep.
Ah, you know that. It is also deep. Many streams of water enter the ocean, right? There is a famous shloka, very famous shloka. Akashat patitam toyam yathagachati sagaram sarvadeva namaskarah keshavam pratigachati. You know, as all raindrops falling from the sky ultimately meet their end in the ocean, like that, prayers offered to all gods ultimately reach the one Bhagavan. When we say this one Bhagavan, you have to take it as Atma Tattva. You pray to Lord Krishna, that is reaching to that Atma Tattva. You pray to your Hannu, that is reaching that Atma Tattva. Okay? The Self, Atma Tattva. That is what it is, Param Atmane Namaha. Param Atma, Param Atma, the highest Atma. Okay? That's why his name is Param Atma. So, coming back to our topic, all the streams enter the ocean. Water from many, many rivers are flowing into it, right? Sometimes they enter gently, sometimes forcefully. In spite of all this, the ocean always remains undisturbed. You got it? Similarly, a sthita prajna does not get impacted by the outer worldly objects. Nothing will happen to him even if he is forced to experience them. These worldly experiences are coming to him as karma phala. You know karma phala. The karma he did in his last janmas. If you do good karma, you will get good results. If you do bad karma, you will get bad results. But know this too. Yogis are beyond this good and bad. Okay? Okay. Ocean sometimes gets storm. You know that, right? But will remain calm underneath the surface. That is the secret. Like that, sthita prajna is sometimes forced to get angry in the outer world. But he is in the realm of calmness deep inside. Do you know Janaka Maharaja? He is a father of
सीता,
सीता देवी, राइट? यू हैव टू से सीता देवी, माँ सीता और सीता देवी. ही वॉज अ ज्ञानी, यू नो, ही हैड टू रूल द कंट्री, नो? ही वॉज इंडीड एज अ राजा, ही वॉज इंडीड इन द मिडस्ट ऑफ सेंस ऑब्जेक्ट्स, राइट? ही वुड हैव गॉट एंग्री मेनी मेनी टाइम्स, नो? बट डीप इनसाइड ही वुड बी काम लाइक ओशन. Such an individual attains peace who is unaffected by the association of the sense objects. It is that simple. Okay? But a person who is kamakami, desirer of desires, will never attain peace. Kamakami. Bhagavan is giving a very beautiful name. Kamakami, desirer of desires. See, one who desires is known as desirer, right? He desires what? He desires desires. See, he desires desires. That is, he craves for desires. One desire is verb, another desire is noun. He desires desires. Such a person will never attain peace. Okay. Now, okay. Mammu just want innu to explain the same thing, the ocean example, because mammu wants to know what innu has understood. Okay. Just tell me a few things.
I understood that when all the rivers like Godavari and other rivers will enter the ocean.
But all the rivers like which, what are the rivers?
Ganga, Yamuna, Godavari.
Okay.
And also Krishna River will enter the ocean.
They all those rivers will enter the ocean, right?
Yes, but the ocean will be calm.
Ocean will be calm all the time.
And the water which came from the rivers, after it comes in the ocean, then it will also become calm.
It will also become calm, no?
Yes.
Sometimes when it is in the river, it is coming forcefully, no?
Yes.
Always doing gala 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 shabda, no?
Yes.
Then what happens?
And when a storm comes, the outer surface of the ocean will be uncalm, but the deep
surface will be
very calm,
no? Like that. Now you should connect that, like that, for a sthita pratnya. Tell me,
the desires will attack but nothing will happen.
Very good. Desires will attack but nothing will happen to him, right? He will be
steady.
He will be unmoved. See? Very good. Uttamam. Ati ati uttamam. This is what a guru needs. When Shishya is imbibing the right thing, guru is always happy. So can you imagine how this gurus like Ramana Maharshi and Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, all of them would be so happy to get a good Shishya. Okay? So Innu is good Shishya for Mammu. Okay? Mammu is secondary. Mammu, all those relationships are secondary. Good Shishyatva, good Gurutva. Okay? Very happy. So, only that person will attain peace who is Achala Pratishtha. One who is unmoving in the self, you know, he only attains shanti. Chala means movement. Achala means absolutely unmoving. See, Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi's main teaching itself is be still. That is God. Be still. That is God. Perfect teaching this is. See, he's saying be still. Summa ir, be quiet, just be. If you have the prarabdha, to be in the worldly life, be there, but be still. Keep doing your swadharma, but be still. Keep doing your regular activities, but be still. Remain undisturbed, remain unmoved like the ocean. May our prajna be sthita. May our wisdom be steady with Bhagavan's grace. See, how many techniques, secret techniques Bhagavan is giving us, no?
Yes.
How beautiful it is, right?
Yes.
We should imbibe it. So that's all for today. So keep in mind, ocean technique, ocean example. We should be calm and composed. Even if we are forced to be angry in the outer world, our heart should be completely composed, calm. Okay? Om Shri Paramatmane Namaha.
Om Shri Paramatmane Namaha.
Uttamam, uttamam. So you are so happily, with all Shraddha, you are imbibing things. Okay. Keep up this attitude, this Shraddha always. Okay, no? Uttamam.